Hey, how you going? I'm just going to show you how to play From the Chest Down by Superheaven today. Just before we jump into it, let you know, if you're after tabs for this song or any of my other songs I've made tutorials for, you can head to Patreon, which is linked below, and sign up there. If you want to support me without signing up to anything, you can buy me a coffee, also linked below. You can follow me on Facebook or Instagram, and I've also put together a Spotify playlist that's got all the songs I've made tutorials for in it, so you can have a listen through that and see if you want to learn anything. Also, if you want to like and subscribe, that'd be a huge help and much appreciated. Anyway, now that's out of the way, let's jump into the lesson. Alright, so for this tune, we're in a different tuning. So we're going to need to tune down a little bit. It's kind of like drop D tuning, but just down a half step. So, from low to high, we've got D flat, A flat, D flat again, G flat, B flat, and E flat. Alright, and then in terms of sections, not too much to learn really. I've pretty much just called it a chorus, which has just got an A and a B riff. They're almost identical, just sort of one note difference. Then we've got a verse, and then we've just got a few lead lines to learn. So I'll go through section by section, give you an example of each part, and then I'll teach it to you. Alright, so we'll start with the chorus, and chorus sounds like this. So just kind of nice and sludgy and just sort of chugging along here. So we're just basically playing an open power chord because we're in that effectively drop D. We're just doing all the open strings, bottom three strings. Just doing that eight times. And just with my left hand, I kind of just hold it just lightly over the top three strings just to mute them in case you hit them when you're strumming. So just do that, and then we've got this, just this shape, a ninth shape that we just move around in a few spots. So we're going to be holding down 5th fret on the 6th and 5th strings, and then 7th fret on the 4th string. So you do that and immediately slide down 2 frets, so then you've got 3, 3, 5. And then we move that same shape up to 8th. So the 8th fret here, so 8th fret on the bottom two strings and 10th fret on the 4th string. And then you just loop that around. So that's the chorus, what I've called chorus A. And chorus B is exactly the same thing, except we just do this bend on the end of it. So it's just... And that's just 10th fret on the 4th string. Just do a bend. It's kind of not, it's not like a full step bend, but just kind of, you know, make it sound a bit funky. Anyway, that's the chorus, and that's sort of the first big bit after the bass intro kicks in. Right, then we've got the verse, and the verse sounds like this. There. Alright, so just sort of like back the gain off just to make it a bit cleaner. But yeah, this bit's pretty straightforward again. We've just got a power chord with like the droning open sixth string going on for the first chord. So open sixth string, fifth fret on the fifth string, and then seventh fret on the fourth string. I just use my pinky for power chords like that. No, not everyone's a fan of that, but just how I play them. But it's good for this because you just sort of like don't need to switch fingers around when you move to different chords. So yeah, just do that 8 times. Then we move up to that same chord that we played in the chorus, which is 8th fret on the 6th and 5th strings and 10th fret on the 4th. So you sort of do it 5 times. And on the 5th, you slide right down to 3rd fret. So same chord shape, 3rd on the 6th and 5th strings and 5th fret on the 4th string. And then repeat. And that is the whole verse. I'm pretty sure it just alternates between these two sections in terms of sort of the rhythm guitar, so what's going on sort of as that foundation. And then we've just got a couple of lead lines that come in roughly halfway through the track. So as best as I can make out, the first one sounds like this. So we're just starting off with this 9th shape. You can do the open 6th string as well if you want. But what it is 5th fret on the 5th string, 7th fret on the 4th string, and 9th fret on the 3rd string. Do this 6 times. And then we go to just an octave shape for the rest of this first lead line. So it's 5th fret on the 5th string and 7th fret on the 3rd string this time. So just got to reshuffle your fingers just a little bit and just muting that 4th string in between. So you do that and then just slide it down 2 frets immediately. So now you've got 3 and 5 on the 5th and 3rd strings. Then we keep that same octave shape, move it up to 7 and 9 on the 5th and 3rd strings again. So you hit it, then we move back down to 5 and 7, strum that, slide it over to 7 and 9, and then slide it over to 8 and 10, and then strum it again, and then we've got, which is just the same octave shape, so 8 and 10, slide it down to 7 and 9, down to 3 and 5. And yeah, just sort of repeat this around. So yeah, that's lead line A. All right, last part to learn is lead line B and C. I've split them up into 2 parts, but they're basically the same thing. There's just 1 note difference. It just sort of alternates between the 2 parts. So, sounds like this. So for lead line B, start with just open 1st string, 1st fret on the 2nd string, 2nd fret slide up to 5 on the 3rd string, then pluck it again, and then again, and then so the third time you sort of play it, you slide back down to 2, and then pull off to open. Then we've just got on the 4th string, 2, 3, 2, then open 6th string. So that's lead line B, and then lead line C is exactly the same thing, except the 2nd note, instead of playing 1st fret on the 2nd string, we play the 3rd fret on the 2nd string.
Thank you.
you just sort of go back and forth between lead line B and lead line C. And that's pretty much the whole thing. Thank you so much for watching and listening. Really appreciate it. Thanks to everyone who supports me on Patreon, like these lovely people. Really do appreciate every bit of support I get through there. And if people buy me a coffee or anything like that, even just leaving comments and liking and subscribing, that is really, really much appreciated. Like I said at the top of the video, you can follow me on all the socials. Check out that Spotify playlist I put together. Again, if you could like and subscribe, that'd be amazing. But that's it for this one. I'll catch you in the next video. Cheers.